Now we will talk about the in-hospital management of diabetic patients. We classify the diabetic patients in the hospital into three categories: the critically ill patient, the non-critically ill patient, and patients who were prepared for a major surgery. The critically ill patient, these are the patients who were admitted to the intensive care unit either due to myocardial infarction, due to stroke, due to a major surgery, whatever the situation, the intravenous insulin infusion is mandatory for the management of the diabetic patient in the intensive care unit. This is a very important quotation. The only solution and the only treatment for the management of the diabetic patient in the intensive care unit is the intravenous insulin infusion, and no rule of the sliding scale, no rule of the sliding scale. Okay, so we give the intravenous infusion, for example, 50 units of act rapid insulin and 50 cc of saline, and we give the infusion in the rate of the equation blood glucose minus 60 multiplied by the multiplier, which is 0.02. This multiplier may be increased or decreased according to the situation, but the main target is to decrease the blood glucose via the intravenous insulin infusion by the equation blood glucose minus 60 multiplied by 0.02. This is done every hour, and we recalculate again, readjust again the infusion rate every hour according to the this equation. When the patient is stable and becomes transmitted from the intensive care unit to the ward outside, we calculate, this is the non-critically ill patient, this is the non-critically, the patient is transmitted from the critically ill situation into a non-critically ill situation, from the intensive care unit outside to the ward. We calculate the total insulin unit in the last 24 hours in the intensive care. For example, 100 units in the last day. So we give 80% only of this total daily dose in the ward for fear of the occurrence of the hypoglycemia. So we give 80 units to the patient in the ward. Half of this 8 unit should be given as a basal insulin, Lantus, Treseba, Toujeo, whatever. This is 80%, 50% means 40 unit is given as a basal insulin, and another 40 unit is subdivided into the three doses, into the three meals according to the meal size of each. This is the non-critically ill patient. So the, in the treatment of the non-critically ill patient, there is no rule of the sliding scale. There is no rule of the sliding scale. We give either in the intensive care unit intravenous insulin infusion, and when the patient becomes stable and not critically ill, so we transmit to the basal bolus therapy. Basal insulin plus bolus before each meal according to the meal size. This should take about 2 weeks or 3 weeks according to the situation and according to the level of the blood glucose. When the blood glucose decreased, so we stop the bolus therapy before meals, and we begin to give the oral therapy with the basal, and then stop the basal and give oral therapy to the end with the follow-up of the patient. Provided that the hemoglobin A1C should be less than 7 to avoid the diabetic complication. For the preparation of the patient for a major surgery, if the patient is controlled and enter to the hospital prepared for a major surgery, the weight of the patient should be multiplied by half unit, and this is the total unit giving to the patient. Provided that the patient has 100 kilos, so we begin by 50 unit of the act rapid insulin as a basal bolus. Again, a basal bolus, not a sliding scale. This 50 unit, half of the 50 unit, 25 given as a basal insulin, Lantus, Treseba, or Toujeo, and the other 50%, which is 25 units, given into three doses according to the meal size, and recalculate again or readjust according to the level of the preprandial blood glucose and the fasting blood glucose.